Welcome back to LonelyMan BGs and this new series on Kingdom Death Monster. This first video will help you to set up your first survivors in Kingdom Death, while in the next video, we'll be learning all about the first story and the White Lion. First things first, you're going to need to pop open that massive box you have displayed above the fireplace and pull out a couple of things. This is the gear grid, which is used to arrange a survivor's gear that the survivor is currently wearing. Now, grab these starting gear cards. Our little friends start out practically naked. They'll each have one cloth armor gear card and a founding stone, which is basically a rock they found on the ground. These are placed right side up on any two spaces in the gear grid. On the left-hand side of the gear grid, there is some information about the survivor's turn, actions they can take, and unarmed combat, which we'll go over later. Next, these survivor record sheets. You'll want to tear out four, one for each survivor. This is where you'll record all the important information about your survivors. Now, grab a pencil and an eraser. You'll need them. First, name your peoples. I've chosen Greek gods. Hephaestus, Aphrodite, Ares, and Artemis. Just don't get too attached. Now, add a 1 to the box labeled survival. That's right, having a name is that important. Survival is the desire to not be brutally slaughtered. In the first story, the survival trait can only be used to dodge. As you continue on your journey, survivors will also be able to dash, encourage, and surge. If you spend any survival, you decrease the number in the survival box by 1. Players will earn more of the survival stuff through gameplay. Now are attributes. Attributes are the survivor's pluses and minuses. In this first story, movement begins at 5, while the others are all listed as 0 besides survival. Movement is the number of spaces a survivor can move each turn. The starting survivors can move up to 5 adjacent spaces each turn as long as said spaces are unoccupied. These spaces are counted cardinally, not diagonally. The rest of the attributes are listed on the record sheets and will be gone over in future videos. Attributes increases and decreases can either be temporary or permanent. The record sheet is used for permanent effects, while these tokens are used for temporary boosts and declines. They are removed at the end of a showdown. Survivors have 5 hit locations. Head, arms, body, waist, and legs. These are places where the survivors are vulnerable to damage, and also where they may wear armor. This lighter box represents a light injury level. This heavier box represents a heavy injury level. As you can see, the head only has a single heavy injury box. Each survivor begins with a cloth starting gear card, which provides 1 armor at the waist. Gotta protect your junk. Given this, we'll write a value of 1 on the waist. This brain box is used to evaluate a survivor's mental fitness. Brains don't have armor, instead, they have insanity. When brains suffer any damage, insanity protects in the same way armor would. Brain damage is the only way the brain can be damaged. Some of these situations get crazy, so the more insane your little dudes are going, the better. Now, weapons. The starting survivors have 2. The founding stone is a rock that your survivor found. It has a special ability shown on the bottom of the card that allows the survivor to throw it at a monster, which causes a critical wound. Afterwards, it is lost forever, archived back to the box. The other weapon a survivor starts with is fist and tooth. Both of these weapons will be gone over in future videos. In this coming video, we'll continue setup of the first story. Thanks for watching.